Signals Research Group is a company that I founded back in 2004. And there's really two aspects to our business. One is a off-the-shelf research product called Signals Ahead, and we have quite a large distribution that receive that. And that's allowed us to do a lot of interesting things, going out and looking at how technologies really perform and doing lots of benchmarking, those types of things. The other aspect of our business is really more so on the consulting side. So it's leveraging what we learned through Signals Ahead, through those research projects, as well as doing a lot of work more so on the economic side. So as operators think about rolling out technologies or vendors, really understanding the economic implications of the decisions that they make. And we've done a lot of work, you know, for a lot of the major mobile operators, infrastructure suppliers, trade associations, et cetera. And is there really a crunch in today's networks? And the answer is kind of yes and no. I think to the extent that an operator does have capacity constraints, it's generally self-inflicted. You know, earlier on, I talked about how some networks are 3.6 versus 7.2, 14.4, 21 meg. If you go from 3.6 to kind of 21 meg, there's about a 4x increase in capacity that you can gain through that, and features like receive diversity, interference cancellation technologies. All of those things, a lot of operators have really failed to implement. You know, so I think to the extent an operator has capacity problems in their network, they really haven't taken full advantage of the technology. You know, they haven't upgraded their backhaul. They could deploy another carrier. You know, there's operators out there that, you know, you deploy a single carrier or two carriers. If you have a capacity problem and you have the ability to deploy a third carrier, why don't you do it? It's interesting, and I've heard this a couple different times. There's a lot of operators out there thinking about turning off 3G first and keeping 2G on.
Why?
You know, well, the argument is, you know, you really need a technology for roaming. You know, and 2G is the common denominator for okay. everybody. 3G a little bit less so, you know, and there may be a cost burden there in terms of handsets and whatnot. So if you can turn off your 3G network, you free up spectrum over time for LTE. And then when you come to important things like roaming, you've got your 2G network in place.